Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI funnel and pyramid chart controls. Use funnel and pyramid charts to represent and compare the proportion of data points in a hierarchical structure through visualization. In this video, I will show you how to add Syncfusion's MAUI funnel and pyramid chart to a MAUI project. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed on your machine. You should also have Visual Studio 2022 installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. I open Visual Studio and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose MAUI app and name my project MAUI example. After that, I continue with the .NET 7 framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Alright, my default application has been created, so let's check the MAUI application's default output by running it. Before that, I will choose an Android emulator from this list and select a Pixel 5 emulator to see the output in that emulator. The application starts to compile the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. Look here, my application says hello world, welcome to MAUI app. Now, I will show you the steps to display Syncfusion MAUI pyramid chart control. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI charts NuGet package. So, I stop the debugging and open the NuGet package manager. In the browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion MAUI charts package and install it in my project. Click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Okay, now let's proceed to initialize the MAUI pyramid chart. Before that, I need to register the Syncfusion.NET MAUI trial license key. I open this app XAML CS file and register the trial license key using the register license method. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, let's proceed to initialize the control. First, I open this main page.xaml file and remove the default content from the content page section. Inside this page, I import the Syncfusion MAUI charts control namespace. And to the local XML namespace, map the default project namespace. And finally, I include the MAUI pyramid chart control. Next, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion core handler by making a call to the method configure Syncfusion core. Okay, next I am going to populate the data for the chart. And let me implement this with the MVVM pattern. First, create a folder called model and add a class named data model. Here, I make this class public and define the fields name and calories with appropriate data types. Next, let me assign values for these fields. To do that, first I create a folder called view model and add a class named DataViewModel. Then, make this class public and define a bindable property called foods of type DataModel class. And add a constructor for the class. Inside this constructor, to the foods property, I add the data objects with the fields, name, and calories. Once it is done, let me navigate to the main page.xaml file to bind the data to the pyramid chart. Here, I will add the binding context to the pyramid chart and access the DataView model class here using this local XML namespace. Lastly, I assign the foods property to the item's source property and map the data source fields, name to the X binding path property, and calories to the Y binding path property. Okay, everything is configured. So, let me save the changes and run this application. Look here, the pyramid chart displayed with defined data points. Next, I am going to set the title for the chart. So, add the pyramid chart title property and define the label tag with the text property and set its value to food comparison. Then, I customize the title by defining the properties text color to red, horizontal text alignment to center, and font size property to large. As you can see, the pyramid chart displays the title food comparison with the customization. Now, let's proceed to see how to add data labels to display information about the data points. To do that, I will define the showDataLabels property and set its value to true. You can see the pyramid chart displaying data labels on each of its data points. Alright, now I am going to add a legend for the chart. A legend gives more information about the series in the chart. First, I define the legend property and add the chart legend inside this chart code. See the pyramid chart displaying the legend at the top and giving information about the series in the chart. Next, let's proceed to make the chart more interactive by adding tooltips to it. To do that, I simply define enable tooltip property and set its value to true. Check now, the tooltip is shown for every data point of the pyramid chart. Notice here, there is no gap between the segments in the pyramid chart, because the gap ratio is set to 0 by default. Suppose I want to add the gap, then I add the gap ratio property with the appropriate value. The segments in the pyramid chart are displayed with a defined gap ratio. So far, I have shown you how to render a pyramid chart and enable its basic features. Now, let's see how to render a funnel chart. To do that, I simply need to change the chart type from the pyramid to the funnel using the SF funnel chart tag. See now, the funnel chart rendered with defined data points. Here, you can see the chart segments are displayed with a gap. If I want to display each segment without a gap, let me set the gap ratio to 0 again. Check now, there is no gap between the segments in the funnel chart. In this video, we have seen how to create a .NET MAUI app using Visual Studio 2022. And add a Syncfusion.NET MAUI funnel and pyramid chart controls to it. We have learned how to render the pyramid and funnel charts with basic features like legend, data labels, and tooltips. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.